Today was a special day, not just because it's Friday and we have a weekend ahead of us, because it was also the last day before Apple and Tesla split. Not with each other, of course, but their stocks. Apple going 4-for-1, Tesla always one better, 5-for-1. Last two times Apple has done a stock split, it's seen big gains a year down the line. So BK, will history repeat itself? Study after study have shown stocks tend to gain 5-8% from just a split alone.
Yeah, which is insane, because as we, everybody has said on this panel, there is no value added to the company because you split your stock. But listen, if people want to buy it and that seems to work, you know, there's an old trader saw that as soon as a stock gets to $90, usually $100 is the next stop, and it kind of acts like a magnet. So these kind of anomalies exist in markets. I wouldn't go and bet the farm on this, and it wouldn't even surprise me is that once these things split, people wake up and look at the Robinhood app and go, oh, wait a second, wait, I can buy a whole lot more. Let me buy some more. And you see this thing going before. But again, it's not going to change the valuation of the story for the company. But hey, stock price might go up.
Grasso?
Yeah, I think you have the ability to, I think you were starting, we were really on the precipice or the cusp of seeing some rotation out of tech and out of growth. I'm sorry, well, out of tech and into value. And I think once Apple started with the split conversation and then Tesla piggybacked it, it really put all of those plans of a rotation on hold. I think what you're going to see now is maybe this won't be what history has shown us, Brian, and maybe you get an opportunity to watch value and cyclicals start to perform on the cusp of what we could see another rotation on the back of what Powell had to say yesterday as well.